Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to design this structure with the help of weldment tools in SOLIDWORKS. Here we will make this I-beam, then this tube, square tip with the help of weldment tools, and later we will add some welding also here. I hope you like it. So let's start to create this structure. For creating a structural member, we need to create a part. Go to new part. Okay. Now here we will define something. Let's go to option, documents property. First we will choose detailing and here select welds, because we want to show the welding. Then go to image quality and let me increase the quality of image. It increase your file size, but quality become good. I'll choose always plain white. Now let's start to create our structural member. For structural member you need a 3D sketch. So I'll choose from here sketch, 3D sketch line. Now you can see here XY, it shows XY direction. So I'll choose from center point, go upward, and again it will show you XY direction. So I'll come to this direction and I'll come to bottom, right click, select, means exit. Now let me define dimension 1000 millimeter, the upper one also 1000 millimeter. Okay, now select these two lines and create a relation equal. That's it, line, and I'll choose from this point. Just see it going x and y direction. We need so in another direction. So what we will do, just press tab key in your keyboard. Now see, it shows y and z direction. So I'll go this direction again, it y z direction. So come down, exit. Here also let me select these two lines, make relation equal. That's it. Now here this line and this line, equal. That's it, line start from this point. Now it is YZ direction, then comes down YZ direction, exit. Now the same here, I'll select this line and this line, equal. The vertical lines equal. Line and connect these two points, exit. Now this is a 3D structure for our structural member or structural frame. We need to create some support also. So let me select here line, select this line to this line and connect with this line, exit. Now let me define this one. From here to here 250 millimeter, 45 degree. The same here 45 degree, and let's check. Okay, it's by default 250. Now the same way we have to define in all directions. So I'm going to skip this one. Now we sketched in all parts. So do one thing, just select this all lines and we will create one relation equal. That's it. Now we will choose one by one each and every parts. It's equal, so we need to define only angle 45 degree. Okay, we need to define the many things. 250, that's it. Here the last one, (250 millimeter). Now that's it, the all members are defined. So this is our 3D structure. Now let's start to create our, we need to add one more in center position. So let me choose your line, and I'll add from this center point to here midpoint. That's it. Exit. Now I start to add structural member. So just go to weldments, choose here structural member. First we will go for ISO standard, then type we will choose beam, SB beam, and size. So 120 by 12, this is our size. So I'll choose first. Now see clearly, second, third, and fourth. Now see, this all four beam comes in one group. Select OK. Now see how the corners are selected. If you need a 45 degree chamfered corner, so how we will do this one? Just right click, edit feature, just come down, and here you can select end meter. Okay, now look, all comes in 45 degree. Edit feature. If you want to change only one things, so once you select this dot point pink, it will ask you how what kind of structural members you joints you need. So I'll choose butt end, and here these two are selected. Select here, okay. Select here, okay. Now look, all are 45 degree, but this one also only a different. So this is the way. If you don't like to make all same, you can make accordingly. Now let me add some more structure. This time I'll go for inches, and I'll choose your square tube, and the size we will keep 2 by 2 into 2.5 inch. This is already available in our system, so that's why I'm going to add this one. I'll select these four members. Okay, this is comes in one group. I'll choose here, okay. Now here see, it is not trimmed here, it is added up to from this point to bottom. We want to trim this face, so how we will do this one? Select here, trim, extend. Bodies to be trimmed, so we need to select all four members. Face plane, I'll select this one. Now it is asking you body 3 keep, see, select discard. See, it is disappeared. The same way we have to do for all. Discard here. For this upper one, discard. We need to keep bottom one, discard. All fours are selected. Okay. Now see, it is trimmed. That's it. Now let's add some structural member here also. So go to structural member, and this time we will go for the same and inches square tube 2 by 2, and let me select here 1 2. Make sure it is attached with this center lines. It is already attached. If not attached, we can add it, it's not a big deal. Select here, okay. Now see, we need to trim many things here. Okay, we need to add, because see how it's going to align here. Edit. Select here, even you can change it from degree also, 45 degree. Now look, let's check 45 degree. Okay, still it is coming out, but that's perfect for this. So that's what we need. So we will keep this one as it is. Trim and extend, we will choose here bodies to be trimmed, 1, 2, and here we will select bodies, 1, 2, 3. See, this is the another method. We are going to here all check extension. If you like, you can select this one, otherwise we don't like extension. Now see, the outer one already written here, discarded. This one center one keep, now outer one discarded. Okay, now look how the welding supporting members tube selected. Now this in same way we will add this structural member to everywhere. So I'm going to skip this sketch, this step. See here, we added support structure, support pipe tube to in all corners. Let me change this color so it looks better. Okay, now it's time to add the last member. So how we will do this one? Just select a structural member, and here we will again choose ISO standard, SBI beam, and 120 by this. I'll choose this line. Now see, it is exact the same beam is going to add here. New group. Okay, so this is what we added. Same here also we need to trim, because you can see it's extended. So the same method we will apply, trim extend. This is the body we want to trim, and here select body. Actually it is the boundary, 1, 2. This is the boundary we want to keep on middle portion, and we want to trimmed which is attached with these two bodies. Okay, look, that's fine. Now let's add weldings. So I'll choose here one face. How you want to add weldings? So first you just go to at the start I told you documents property detailing, and here select welds. Okay, and go to view, select here hide and show, and here select all annotations because it helps to show you welding sign, and here select weld bit. Once you select weld bit, so the weld bit will appear here. Now here select weld bit. Now here we need to select the two path faces, one face, second face. So I'll select this one face and second face this one. Now you can see this pink mark is welding mark, but this is only up to the limit, up to this faces. Here we have option. Let me select 5, and I'll choose here tangent propagation. See, the all line will be select. Even you can define weld symbol here. Select here weld symbol. Most is here you will find multiple number of symbols for welding, but we will go for defined one. See, so we will choose as it is, so it will selected by default. Okay, now you can see here 5 welding marks already going to show. Select. Okay, now see, this is the welding bit going to show you here. Now here we will show one more method. Again select weld bit, and here select smart weld selection tool. Once you select this tool, it will just press your mouse and drag these two faces. See, automatically it is selected here. If you will choose all round option will not work, so choose tangent propagation. Now see the welding, 5 millimeter. Okay, That's it. Now let's add welding somewhere in tube. Okay, let's add here. Let me choose here weld bit smart. I'll drag up to these two faces. Now it is automatically selected. Now here, this is round or complete surface, so you can select here all around or even tangent propagation. There is no change, nothing difference. It's up to you. Okay, now see, so this is the simple tutorial of weldment, how to create a structural member in SolidWorks with the help of weldment tools. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Here, let me hide this. Now these are the welding members designs. In our next part 2, we will see how to create the drawings for this all structure, how to keep separate everything. So thanks for watching.